In this video clip, we'll present how to create a freeform surface in Rhinoceros, which will subsequently be transformed into an ARCHICAD morph element. We'll be using Rhinoceros and Grasshopper, developed by Robert McNeil and Associates, and ARCHICAD, developed by Graphisoft. The new connection between Rhinoceros, Grasshopper, and ARCHICAD offers seamless bi-directional geometry transfer between these applications. After installing Rhinoceros with the Grasshopper add-on and ARCHICAD on your computer, please make sure that the Grasshopper ARCHICAD Live Connection tool is also installed and running. We'll start the design in Rhinoceros by using its extensive freeform modeling toolset. Afterwards, we'll continue the modeling work in Grasshopper. Finally, we'll demonstrate how to continue the work using a professional BIM environment provided by ARCHICAD. Let's create some curves in Rhinoceros as presented on the screen. Let's switch to Grasshopper now and add some curve parameters. We will associate these parameters with the curves we created earlier. Please note that this tutorial video was created to present the Rhinoceros-Grasshopper-ARCHICAD connection. Please check out the separate training materials for Grasshopper and Rhinoceros. Now we'll move one of the curves by applying the corresponding command in Grasshopper. We can use the slider to define the distance in Grasshopper. While Rhinoceros provides instant visual feedback on the procedure. Now we'll use the loft component to create a surface between the 3D curves. We'll use the divide domain and isotrim components of Grasshopper to divide the surface. The exact number of surface divisions can be controlled by using a number slider. We've divided the surface into 9 subsurfaces. The results are visible in the perspective view of Rhinoceros. We can add an output panel to check the number of surfaces that were generated. Now let's continue and deconstruct the surfaces. Once again, we can check the exact result of the procedure. We can see that 9 separate vertex packages have been created, and each package contains 4 points, as the result of the deconstruction. Each of the 9 surfaces have 4 vertex points. The geometry of these points are the result of the last procedure. Let's continue to create the triangular surfaces. To be able to do this, we must first identify those vertex points which will be used to define the individual triangles. Now let's add multiple instances of the list length component. We need 4 instances, because each of the previously deconstructed surfaces had 4 vertex points. These points need to be regrouped so that they can be used for the vertexes of the new triangles. Using the list length, subtraction, and list item components, we can determine and collect the appropriate vertex coordinates. In practice, this means that we will create a group of coordinates that consist of all the primary vertexes of the decomposed rectangles. Another group will collect the secondary vertexes, and so on. As a result, we create 4 different groups of point coordinates. Once the vertex groups are available, we'll load these 4 groups to the 4-point surface component. This creates triangular surfaces out of the vertexes. Please note that the triangular surfaces have now been created and are visible in the perspective view of Rhinoceros. The original freeform surface created in Rhinoceros and Grasshopper is now triangulated. All we need to do is to adjust the desired number slider in Grasshopper to increase the number of triangular surfaces in Rhinoceros. We'll transfer the new triangulated surface to ARCHICAD with the help of morph components. Let's display the Grasshopper connection palette in ARCHICAD and start the bi-directional live connection. The morph elements generated by morph components in ARCHICAD are full-fledged BIM elements. First, we will convert the triangular surfaces created earlier to mesh type data. We will do the conversion with the help of the morph component and the simple mesh component in Grasshopper. As a result, we'll create a mesh with the minimum amount of polygons possible. Now we'll add the single mesh component to the Grasshopper project. Then we'll connect the simple mesh with the ARCHICAD morph component in Grasshopper, and the triangular elements are instantly visible in the 3D view of ARCHICAD. Let's repeat the same steps with the other set of triangular surfaces as well. Please note that mesh or curve Grasshopper components can be transferred to ARCHICAD as morph elements. Now the entire freeform surface, combined using triangles, is visible in ARCHICAD. We may also change the overall shape of the surface. Let's switch to Rhinoceros and modify any of the initial freeform curves we used to create the surface. Please note that all changes made to the Rhino model are quickly visible in ARCHICAD. The Grasshopper components will use the modified curve geometry, and this will also be instantly translated to the BIM environment as native ARCHICAD morph building elements. Let's now select one of the morph-generating components in Grasshopper. Please note that the corresponding triangles in the ARCHICAD 3D view are also selected. Now we'll show you how to change an element setting, such as the material of the selected panels. The Grasshopper ARCHICAD Live connection can not only generate new elements in ARCHICAD, but it also enables us to control the most important element parameters as well. Each ARCHICAD element type has its own settings component on Grasshopper's ARCHICAD tab. In this case, we will add the Morph Settings component to the Grasshopper project. This enables us to control the building material and the layer of the generated morphs. First, let's modify the material with the help of the Building Material Input node. Input nodes are special interface elements that store a list of values received from ARCHICAD. The available values are continuously refreshed so that they always correspond to the set of values contained in ARCHICAD. Click on the right side of the input node to access the list of building materials, and select the glass material. As soon as the Morph Settings node is connected to the generating component, half of the roof panels become transparent. Thanks to the live connection, we can use Grasshopper's number slider to edit the number of the triangulated surfaces. Let's continue with setting the layer of the panels. As per the default settings, morphs were generated onto the layer called Morph General. We want to change this and place the panels onto a layer called Roof. Let's return to Grasshopper and place a layer input node onto the canvas. Bring up the input selection panel by clicking on the right side of the input node. After browsing through the list, we realize that there is no layer called Roof yet. So let's create one back in ARCHICAD. As you can see, the list of the layer input node in Grasshopper has been updated, and now offers the newly created roof layer. As soon as we connect the input node to the Morph Settings component, all the transparent panels are repositioned onto the layer called Roof. We can apply the same change to the darker panels by connecting their generating component with the layer input node through another instance of the Morph Settings component. Let's unlock the selected Morph Triangles in ARCHICAD to enable further editing operations. We can do this by activating the Edit, Locking, Unlock command. Now let's open the Morph Selection Settings dialog in ARCHICAD. Here we can edit the various parameters of the selected Morph elements that are not available through the Morph Settings node. We can adjust the floor plan and section display, define IFC parameters, and so on. Thanks to the new bi-directional live connection between Rhinoceros, Grasshopper, and ARCHICAD, designers can benefit from the best of three worlds, create freeform models in Rhino, and develop the design using the algorithmic capabilities of Grasshopper, and finally, harvest all the benefits of the design provided by the industry-leading BIM environment of ARCHICAD.